The cast iron skillet is a culinary multi-tool with plenty of knockout advantages over its typical aluminum siblings. But unlike any other tool in your kitchen's arsenal, these pans pack some kitchen controversy over the do's and don'ts of maintenance. Today we're talking the chemistry of why you should get on board that cast iron train, and once on board, we're going to show you the right way to treat your cast iron skillet. It's time to settle this, folks, once and for all. For those of you who aren't privy to the cast iron life, let me brief you on why these pans absolutely rule. First of all, they're tough and seamless, hence the cast in cast iron. Their full metal build allows you to cook on the stove and in the oven. Unlike most pans, the dense iron helps these pans hold on to heat much longer. Most important of all, cast irons can become non-stick if treated correctly or well seasoned. The surface of a cast iron skillet is covered in little pores and imperfections that food can seep into when being cooked. Heated proteins can chemically bond to these imperfections, making the prospect of sunny side up eggs seem impossible. Well-seasoned cast iron pans have a special layer of bonded residue from foods that block those super sticky, annoying interactions from happening. When fats, like in cooking oils or butter, are heated up while in contact with metals, they polymerize. That is, the fat molecules link together to form a plastic-like coating on the pan's cooking surface. The more you cook, the more this polymerized layer builds up. Unfortunately, it does take time. So let's say you just bought a secondhand cast iron that's not even close to being correctly seasoned. Here's what you're gonna do to bring it up to speed. Pour a half a cup of salt into the pan, and using a paper towel, scour the pan with salt in order to remove all dust and impurities from the surface. Then clean it in a sink and dry it off. Set your oven to self-cleaning mode and stick the pan in for a solid 3 hours. Take it out to cool and reset the oven to 232 degrees Celsius. Using another paper towel, fully cover the surface of the pan in an oil high in unsaturated fat, and then put your oil-coated pan in the oven for another 30 minutes. You should notice that it's a bit darker than before. Let it cool, coat it in oil again, and set it in the oven. You're going to repeat this 3 more times. By the time you're done, your pan will be much deeper black due to the layers of polymerized fat, and thus much more stick-free. So about maintaining that seasoning, there's a lot of disagreements out there about the do's and don'ts, so today we're going to play a little fact or fiction. 1. Never use metal utensils on cast iron. Fiction. A good seasoning is way tougher than metal, so pay no mind. 2. Lard and bacon fat are the best seasoning oils. Fiction. These two are extremely high in saturated fats. Unsaturated fats are far more reactive than saturated fats, which means that flaxseed and vegetable oils will do a way better job than these two. 3. Never under any circumstances you ever use soaps on cast iron pans. Fiction. Soaps are gentle on basically everything except grease, so you can use soaps no problem on your fancy polymerized seasoned pan. 4. Always dry your pan immediately after cleaning. Fact. Iron is prone to rusting, people. Dry it with a towel or reheat it in the oven to dry it faster. 5. Coat your pan in oil when done cleaning. Fact. Oil helps keep a protective barrier to stop any moisture in the air from affecting the iron. And also, it's going to help with the coming level of polymerization next time you cook with it. Folks, if you want to learn more about cast irons and any other kitchen-related science, check out this brilliant book, The Food Lab, Better Home Cooking Through Science. A link's down in the description. Do you have any other cast iron tips we missed? Post them down in the comments. Subscribe and thumbs up on the way out. We'll see you again soon.